So now we'll go to the next important technique called as voltage division technique. Okay, so similarly, it's similar to voltage division technique. We also have current division technique. So first, we will see voltage division technique. See, and see the condition given. It is applicable only to series connected elements because in parallel the voltage is same. So in parallel, there is no need for measuring voltage because voltage across all the components are going to be same. So the in series only the voltage gets split, right? So voltage division technique is applicable only for series connected elements. So I have taken a simple circuit. First, we will do the analysis by normal method KVL. We will find the voltage across R1 and R2. Then for the same network, we will apply voltage division technique and we will see how we get the answer in one step. The conventional method will take 10 to 20 steps. But this voltage division technique will give you the answer in single step. It's a shortcut technique for KVL. So if you want to find voltage across any element in a series connected network, if you apply voltage division technique, you will get the answer in few seconds and very few number of steps. So I have taken this diagram. See the network shown here. You have a DC voltage source. I have two resistors R1 and R2 in series. And the current is assumed to flow away from the source. So current is flowing in clockwise direction. And I am marking the polarity also. Oh, V1 is the voltage across R1. V2 is the voltage across R2. So if I want to find V1, what should I do first? I want to find the current. So apply Kirchhoff's voltage law here. So can somebody say what is the Kirchhoff's voltage law equation? I'll call someone to say. Jeevanand, you are there.
Yes, sir.
Can you apply Kirchhoff's voltage law here to this network? Say me the equation for KVL for this network.
1 minute, sir.
Yeah. You can see the diagram and say. You need not draw and then see. Just see the diagram and say. Current flow, which polarity, which just say the thing.
1 minute, sir.
Yes.
What equation want to say, sir?
I want you to say Kirchhoff's voltage law.
Voltage law, sir. Okay.
Yes. Kirchhoff's voltage law.
Okay, sir.
Do it fast. What is the sign of voltage source? How the current is traveling from plus to minus or minus to plus?
Minus to plus.
So what is the polarity of voltage source?
Plus.
Okay. What will you write? Plus. What you write? Plus.
V.
Then
equal to
I have written equal to, but what will actually come? Plus V. Then what is the next component across R1? What is the voltage?
Minus V1.
Yes, so plus V, minus V1, then across R2,
minus V2,
then equal to algebraic sum of voltages in network is equal to what? What
zero.
Does Kirchhoff? Zero. Yes, very good. So V minus V1 minus V2 equal to zero. So you will get V is equal to V1 plus V2. Yes?
Okay.
So V is equal to V1 plus V2. Thank you, Jeevanand. You can mute yourself. What is V1? Voltage across R1. Again, go back to Ohm's law. So V is equal to I into R1 plus I into R2. You know, when the elements are connected in series, the same current is going to flow. So I'm using the same current I you see here. Now I can take I as common. Now I'll get the value of current I is equal to V by R1 plus R2. Is this clear till now how to find current? Now how to find voltage across resistance R1? Again, Ohm's law. Voltage across resistance R1 is V1. V1 equal to I into R1. So I, you know, V by R1 plus R2 into R1. Same way, voltage across R2 is V2 equal to I into R2, which is V into R2 by R1 plus R2. See, so far, we have found out voltage across R1 and R2 using conventional method, using KVL. We have not applied voltage division technique. We have used KVL to find the voltage across R1 and R2. Is this technique clear? Now, we are going to see how this technique is simplified by using voltage division technique. Is this basic method clear to everyone? How to find voltage across R1 and R2? Any confusion? Is it okay?
No, sir.
The conventional
yes,
method?
Sir.
No, sir, no,
yes, sir.
See, if the current direction you assume is proper, then everything will fall in place. Otherwise, you have to think and properly do it. Okay, now listen carefully. I'm going to say voltage division technique. See, the formula is given: voltage across any resistor equal to total voltage which is supplied by the circuit into that resistor across which you measure, divided by that resistor plus opposite resistor. So this is the formula for voltage division technique. I'll make it very, very clear to you. See, first I am finding voltage across R1. So what is voltage across R1? I have denoted it as V1. So V1 equal to total voltage supplied. What the total voltage supplied by the source in the diagram?
V.
V, correct? So it is V. Into across what resistor I am measuring the voltage?
R1.
So numerator you have into R1. See, the numerator, that resistor across which you are going to measure. So V into R1 divided by that resistor, again R1. Now in the diagram, you hide R1. What resistor is remaining?
R2.
That is your opposite resistor. So V divided V into R1 by R1 plus R2. So the answer finally is V1 equal to V into R1 by R1 plus R2. So what answer we got in normal method? V into R1 by R1 plus R2. Now in voltage division technique, I got the answer in single step without finding current. Is this technique clear? Any doubt?
Sir, if more than two resistors are there?
More than two resistors, means assume you have R1, R2, R3. Across R1, I'm going to measure voltage. So if you hide R1, what are the remaining resistance available? What is the opposite resistance?
R2 and R3.
How are R2 and R3 connected?
Series.
What you should do?
Add.
So what will be the opposite resistance effectively? It is R2 plus R3. Okay?
Okay.
Yes.
Similarly, what is voltage across R2? So V2 equal to total supplied voltage is V into that resistance is R2 divided by that resistance is R2, and you have to hide R2 in the diagram. So if you hide R2 in the diagram, if you hide R2, the remaining resistance is R1. So the opposite resistance is going to be R1. So V2 will be equal to V into R2 by V1, R1 plus R2. So you compare the answer what we got in the conventional method, same thing, V into R2 by R1 plus R2. Any doubt anybody is having in this voltage division technique?
No, sir.
See, this should make your job very simple, voltage division technique. Because if even a circuit is complex, you apply voltage division technique properly, you can measure the voltage across any resistance in any part of your circuit very, very easily. And remember, you apply voltage division technique only for circuits having series number of elements in series, because in parallel, I told you the voltage is going to be the same. Across each element, the voltage is going to be same. We'll do a sample problem. So see the problem which is shown in your screen. You have a 5 volt power supply and you have two resistors, 5 ohm and 10 ohm in series. Find V1 and V2 by voltage division technique. I am going to give you a minute time. Please solve it and say me the answer. Be ready with the answer. Once I ask someone to say the answer, we'll cross check. I hope everybody is able to see the sum which I am projecting. So you have a simple circuit, 5 volt power supply. You have two resistors, 5 ohm and 10 ohm in series. And the voltage across 5 ohm and 10 ohm is V1 and V2. So I want to find V1 and V2 using voltage division technique. Please do it and have the answers ready. Even if you are struggling or not able to understand, even if you do it wrongly, please attempt doing it, and only you will know where you are making mistakes. Just by sitting simply, you cannot learn anything. So attempt the problem and see where you are wrong. We can correct it at any point of time. No issues at all.
Sir, completed, sir.
Completed. Others?
Completed, sir.
Okay, we'll pick someone to answer. Vanessa is there. Vanessa?
Yes, sir.
On a, can you say the answer?
Yes, sir. 1.66.
V1 is 1.67. Okay, 1 point. I told you to approximate two decimal place. You get 1.6666, right?
Yes, sir.
So if you approximate, the answer is 1.67. Okay, we are V2.
3.33.
Is everyone getting the same answer?
Yes, sir.
Anybody went wrong and not getting the answer, please open your mouth and ask doubts.
So, can we give the answer in fraction form?
Better
like
to write it in
decimals.
Yes, you can have it in fraction, but better to write in decimals because the answer key will be given in decimals only.
Oh, okay, sir.
Better have it in two decimal place. You write in fraction as well as two decimal place, so that should be fine. And how do you know this answer is correct or not? How to cross check?
By adding the two voltages, sir.
Yes. See, in circuits, you always have an option to cross check. Add the two voltage, what do you get?
5
volts, sir.
Yes. So your answer is correct. So the total voltage is 5 and it is getting split across 5 ohms and 10 ohms. That's 1.67 volts and 3.33 volts. That is the Kirchhoff voltage law is indirectly verified here. I again repeat, if you find voltage across 5 ohms, this 10 ohm will be your opposite resistance. If you find voltage across 10 ohms, 5 ohms will be your opposite resistance. So that's why the formula you see, 5 into 5 by 10, this 5 and 5 are that resistance and 10 is your opposite. Again, 10 by 10 plus 5, this 10 and 10 are that resistance, 5 is going to be your opposite resistance. So indirectly, KVL is verified. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Go to the next problem. See, it is your responsibility to unmute and ask doubts if you have, because in online class, we cannot physically see you. We cannot go into your mind and see what is running into your mind. So please, if you have, since we are into the basics now, so please, if you have any doubts, please unmute yourself and ask any doubt you have. If you are clear, I don't have any issues, but if you have doubt, your study should not persist with doubt. Okay? So now the next problem.
Sir.
Yes.
A doubt, sir.
One second. Others, please take this problem and keep solving. I'll clear this doubt and come. Yes.
So what happened when we have three resistors, sir?
That's what I told, right? Assume if you have three resistors, R1, R2, R3. Okay, you are finding voltage across R1 means. What if you hide R1, what resistors are there? If you hide R1, what two resistors will be there? Hello, Kaviyarasu?
R2 and R3, sir.
R2 and R3, how are they? They are in series, right?
Yes, sir.
Series na enna pannu resistance. What will you do when resistance are in series?
Add pannu, sir.
So what will be the opposite resistance now? It is not R2, it is going to be?
R2 and R3.
R2 plus R3. Okay, so
okay.
The voltage will be V into R1 by R1 plus R2 plus R3. Is it clear now?
Okay, sir.
Now try the problem which you are seeing on the screen.
Okay, sir.
Same way, series. Yes, anybody is having doubt?
No, sir. I just want you to scroll up, sir.
It's okay now. You are seeing the problem. I am not showing
yes,
the answer
sir, yes.
Purposely. I am waiting for your answers. This problem you cannot do it directly. First, we have to assume the resistances as we did previously, RA, RB, RC, and then find RA, RB, RC, and oh, then
sir.
apply voltage division technique. That should be making your job simple.
So finish, sir.
So take the first resistance as RA, the parallel combination as RB, and this three parallel combination as RC. First, find RA, RB, and RC. Then your job could be simple. See, they did not ask find voltage across specific resistance, correct? So they have asked generally V1, V2, V3. So it is straightforward question. So RA is 1 ohm as per the diagram, only one resistor. And RB is going to be 4 2 parallel
ohms.
To 4.
2 ohms, sir.
Yes, 2 ohms, good. And RC is 6 parallel to 6 parallel to 6. So it is going
ohms.
To be
again 2 ohms.
Again 2 ohms. Ohms. Now apply the voltage division technique. So V1 equal to, see here I have a mark. And take the answer for V1.
One volt, sir.
5, total supplied voltage is 5 into that resistor is RA divided by that resistor is RA, and opposite you see RB and RC are in series. See, even though RB and RC individually has parallel resistance, don't worry about that. Effectively, RB and RC are in series. That is what is required for us. So V1 is 1 volt. See, in the exam, don't write this shortcuts that resistor opposite resistor and all. Directly apply the formula. This I have marked this just for your understanding so that you can interpret this better. So in the diagram, you see the diagram and write the formula for voltage division technique, hiding the resistance and seeing what is going to be your opposite resistance. V1 is 1 volt. I think everybody should get that very simple. C for V2?
2 volt. 2 volt, sir.
Yes, I'm also getting 2 volt. And V3 should also be same.
2 volts.
I didn't find V3 actually. Yes, V3 will also be 2 volt. Add all 2 plus 2 plus 1, you get 5, which is the supply voltage, 5 volt. So your answers are correct. I am again keeping the slowly scrolling for the expression for V1 outright. V1 and the answer for V1. V1 is going to be 1 volt. If you don't include both RB and RC here, the answer goes wrong. Same way, V2. Again, it is RA plus RC. If you don't do that, the answer is wrong. V2 is 2 volt and V3 is also 2 volt. I didn't do it. I forgot it. V3 is also 2 volt. Anybody is having doubt? If you have doubts, please, otherwise we'll go to current division technique. See, this voltage division technique is advanced form of KVL. KVL in very shortcut form is going to be voltage division technique. And this voltage division technique, instead of finding current, you can directly find the voltage using this formula. But previously, if you do it using a conventional method, you have to first find current, then apply Ohm's law and find voltage. But when you use VDT, voltage division technique, you can find voltage directly without the necessity to find current. That is the advantage. Anybody is having doubts in voltage division technique?
No, sir.
Yes.
No, sir.
Others, if you are silent, can I assume that you are clear with everything?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.